despite braving rains. So welcome. Let me start with the context for the business. The environment remained challenging. Market recovery, yes, is stabilized, particularly in rural. And the deflationary trend that we see in input costs continued, which in turn resulted in price growth in commodity-led categories coming off. Overall competitive intensity continued to remain high. In this backdrop, we have delivered another quarter of profitable volume-led growth, where the domestic consumer business grew by 5%, which on an underlying basis, once you add back the impact of phase out of excise duty benefits, grew by 7%. Underlying volume growth came in at 6% and was broad-based across categories. The quarter saw negative price growth arising essentially due to two factors. One, the benefit of commodity costs in our soaps and detergent segment was passed on to consumers, as we alluded to earlier from our December quarter results, through lower prices. That is one. And second, the phase out of excise duty benefits, which we have been calling out again, impacted the price growth in our soaps and personal products segments. Talking about the individual segmental performance, soaps and detergents delivered profitable volume-led growth in a price deflationary environment, and the healthy volume growth in this segment was almost entirely offset by the price degrowth. In soaps, it was a premium segment that actually delivered well, notably Dove, which delivered double-digit volume growths. And in laundry, Surf and Rin continued to perform well and to drive category premiumization, while Vim led the performance in household care. Moving on to personal products, I am pleased to say that personal products delivered one of its strongest ever performance in this quarter, led by a strong delivery in skin, in hair, and in color cosmetics. In skincare, volume-led double-digit growth drove the performance in Fair and Lovely, in Pond's, in Vaseline, and in Lakme, almost all brands performing well there. And in hair care, we sustained a strong volume-led double-digit growth this quarter as well, with all brands, Dove, Clinique Plus, Tresemme, Sunsilk, all doing very well. In oral care, Close-Up registered double-digit growth on the back of impactful activation, while color cosmetics continue to perform very well on the back of very strong innovation pipeline. Moving on to our foods and refreshments portfolio, beverages saw broad-based growth across brands, and tea delivered double-digit growths with healthy volumes. As for packaged foods, market development continued to be the key growth driver, where Kissan again delivered one of its strongest performance in both ketchups and jams. Knorr grew well, despite a sharp downturn in the market post the noodles issue. Quality Walls did well, while Magnum continued to maintain its good progress. It's particularly pleasing to note that this is now the seventh quarter of consistent double-digit growth in the packaged foods business. As for water, Pureit continued to grow ahead of the market, but in a sharply slowing consumer durables market. Our growth drivers continue to be a relentless focus on innovation, a strong focus on market development, impactful activation, and sharper in-market execution. Those growth drivers continue to remain the same. And because of this, of sustained focus on market development, we saw very good growth in emerging categories like hand wash, fabric conditioners, dishwash liquids, green tea, premium coffee, and the like. And to drive this, our investment behind brands was sustained at competitive levels, where overall A&P was higher by 210 crores almost, plus 200 bips for the quarter, and almost 22% higher than the previous year same period. So with this context, let me turn to our financial performance for the quarter. Our turnover, as I said earlier, grew 5%, but on an underlying basis was 7%. PBIT margins improved by 140 bips. Resulting in a PBIT growth of almost 15%. Cost of goods sold, as I alluded to the falling commodity prices earlier, was lower by 380 bips due to lower commodity costs as well as the savings programs that we continue to drive despite the low inflation. And profit after tax before exceptional item, or PATBEI as we call it, stood at 1,053 crores, up 3%, impacted by the rising tax rates due to the fiscal benefit sunset. Net profit at 1,059 crores was flat, impacted by a profit from sale of investments in the prior year of almost 106 crores. So in the base year had 106 crores in the base, which is not there in the current year, and hence while you see a PBIT growth of 15%, that's translating to a net profit growth of almost flat. So to summarize the quarter, we delivered another quarter of profitable volume-led growth. Our brands are healthy and we continue to invest behind them. And as we focus on growing our consumer franchise while driving profitability, this becomes even more important in a deflationary environment, and we are staying true to that. Looking ahead, in the near term, improved market growth is dependent on rural. Commodity costs are expected to continue to remain benign, which means price growth will be an area where we will see deflation in the going quarters as well. That's what we see. Phasing out of fiscal benefits will continue for another couple of quarters. The impact of that will come for another couple of quarters. And therefore, in this kind of a context, we remain focused on sustaining profitable volume-led growth. And as far as the medium term is concerned, we continue to remain positive on the medium to long-term growth story of the country. And we believe we are well positioned with our brands and capabilities to leverage this as consumers and markets evolve. And our strategy remains unchanged, which is consistent, competitive, profitable, and responsible growth. With this, over to you guys for questions.